talk about the merger?
Yes, at this time, we have a representative from Waste Management to talk about the merger between Advanced Disposal and Waste Management.
All right, just a little bit of background. Alex School here, Mary Wilkerson, and I'm real familiar with Dallas, but too familiar with the regional commission, is that what you call them now?
Right.
I used to work with South Georgia RDC, and the building was about falling apart back in the 80s and 90s, so I guess I'm kind of a full circle. And then I worked for Reynolds County Board of Commissioners, worked for Fred Loach and Lee Gilmore, and Mike Kaysen was the city manager at the time, and Larry Hanson was the public works, or the parks and recreation, so I kind of know my way around. Waste Management and Advanced Disposal merged. The closing took place October 30th. The announcement was April 15th, 2019. So through COVID, we had to wait. I think it's a good marriage. I'll be retained. Greg Walk, your normal representative, will be retained. These are Evergreen Landfill. And all of your employees and the collection people and the management people at Valdosta will be retained. So there's going to be no changes. It was a $4.9 billion purchase, number one, bought number three. And our contractual arrangements, actually the way it's worded is two companies merged as one. And they're going to retain the Waste Management brand because it's nationally known. I think over time you may see some trucks and some carts and some dumpsters and some roll-off containers with the WM logo. That may take a year or so or more. So far, they've been very good to us. It's just like joining a bigger family. Our contract doesn't change, it remains the same, and actually Advanced Disposal is a subsidiary of Waste Management, so therefore there's no prior written consent.
So there's still going to be an advance?
Yeah, there's no prior written consent to the Deep South Solid Waste Authority, and I just wanted to come down, because we also have a farmhouse outside of Culpeper County. I live in Sugar Hill, which is suburb of North Atlanta, and it's always good to get back down here. But I just wanted to come down and tell you in person what happened. You know, we don't see any major changes. I think it's a good marriage. I think, as a matter of fact, I think it makes South Georgia and the Deep South Solid Waste Authority stronger, because Waste Management has so many more resources that we've ever dreamed of. So, and I can explain this to you at the January meeting for those that weren't here. But I just want to tell y'all face to face. It's not going to be a mass exodus. You've got a good crew here in South Georgia. We pump a lot of money into your economy with our hauling and our disposal assets. And if you have any questions, please feel free to ask.
You mentioned you're the mayor.
I'm the mayor of Sugar Hill as well. So I know local government. So, and I studied a master's in public administration, and then, of course, learned from Mike Case and Lee Gilmore and that whole group a long time ago. And I was telling Amy that with the South Georgia RDC, its old location, that place was falling apart. There's a trailer in the back and there were holes in it. And that's when Hal Davis ran it. Hal Davis and John Leonard and Martin Files for those days.
So I'm employed there.
I'm just Martin. Is he still around?
I think he still is about Austin.
In a financial way. I actually called him when they did do something.
He's still married in the morning and they got a bunch of grandkids who are doing it. Anyway, I drove 3.5 hours to tell you that. I'm going to farm a house with it.
Yeah, you need to like check that out. Like,
yeah,
sure. I'm farm.
Yeah, it's out in Meigs, out that way, in Thomas County. It's good to see y'all again, and like, yeah, I think Greg and I, Greg Walker, we work well together. And, you know, we plan on sticking around.
Thanks for coming down.
Thank you.